All right, well, I guess let's go since it's 10:30. Okay, Mr. Bernie, are you ready to go? Oh, I know that. All right, this week, I have a couple of new members today, so I'm going to explain to them. Oop, we have a couple of new members today. I don't know, we get an echo here. So we play the songs twice, so we can screw them up twice. So, but anyway, so you get a feel of the song, because it's pretty eclectic, usually programmed pretty eclectic. There's everything from country and western, which is what this first one is, or country rather, to classic standards and so forth. So we go through them, so a lot of times people don't know the song. I recommend that when you're on our group website to download the stuff and then go to YouTube, because all of these are keyed in exactly the key that was the original recording. So if you see Patti Loveless up there, you just look for YouTube, try to think about Elvis, Patti Loveless, and these chords, you can play along with the songs. So, are we ready to? Okay. So welcome to June Laugh 2023. I want to make sure that the people on YouTube understand that this is a educational meeting. Everybody is here to learn songs, learn how to play, learn techniques, and so forth. And so this is for just educational use only. We recognize respect copyrights, and so we are not trying to steal anybody's music. And this is, nobody is paying for this this class. So just please don't take it down. So. Anyway, here we go. So let's go with this first one. This was Patti Loveless in 1994, did this song, and it sat at 20 weeks on the chart, hit number three in 1994. And it's a cute song. So here we go. One, two, three, four. Try to think about Elvis, Memphis, Oprah in the afternoon. I try to think about the palm trees, fig leaf, creature from the Black Lagoon. I try to think about high heels, good deals, anything to get me through. I just can't concentrate. You're all I think about these days. Try to contemplate the cosmos, what goes round and round the sky at night. I try to think about champagne, freight trains rolling right out of sight. I try to focus on the headlines, street crimes, everything I think is mine. I just can't concentrate. You're all I think about these days. My mind wanders where it will. When it settles right on you, I forget what I should say. I forget what I should do. I forget what I should do. Try to think about Shakespeare, leap year, the Beatles or the Rolling Stones. I try to think about hairdos, tattoos, sushi bars and saxophones. I try to talk about talk shows, new clothes, but I guess I should have known. I just can't concentrate. You're all these days. You're all I think about these days. Okay, that was way slower than it should be. But anyway, anybody get lost? Shouldn't on this one. It's a nice, simple song. All right, now let's pick this thing up and play it the way it's supposed to be. Try to think about Elvis, Memphis, Oprah in the afternoon. I try to think about palm trees, fig leaves, the creature from the Black Lagoon. I try to think about high heels and good deals, anything to get me through. I just can't concentrate. You're all I think about these days. I try to contemplate the cosmos, what goes round and round the sky at night. I try to think about champagne, freight trains slowly rolling out of sight. I try to focus on the headlines, street crimes, every time I think I might. I just can't concentrate. You're all I think about these days. My mind wanders where it will. When it settles right on you, I forget what I should say. I forget what I should do. Instrumental. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My mind wanders where it will. When it settles right on you, I forget what I should say. I forget what I should do. Try to think about Shakespeare, leap year, Beatles or the Rolling Stones. I try to think about hairdos, tattoos, and saxophones. I try to think about the talk shows, new clothes. I guess I should have known. I just can't concentrate. You're all I think about these days. You're all I think about these days. There we go. It's actually leaving a little faster than that, but that'll get us going.
Yeah, it's kind of a real
straight.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's a power song, really. All right, let's do Primrose Lane. This was Jerry Wallace, Primrose Lane. I failed to tell you, we're going to be doing quite a few key change songs today. First one had a little key change there at the end. This one has a key change on the second page. So you go from D to D sharp 7 and move up a half step. But this was quite a popular song. Went to number 8 in 1959. Hiya. All right, here we go. 1 and 2 and. Primrose Lane, life's a holiday on Primrose Lane. Just a holiday on Primrose Lane. With you. Explain when we're walking down Primrose Lane, even roses bloom in the rain with you. Sweet perfume, those little red roses.
Primrose Lane. Life's a holiday on Primrose Lane. Just a holiday on Primrose Lane with you.
I messed up on the key change. I think I was playing G instead of G sharp.
I believe you were.
I believe I was totally,
But I made the same mistake for a few minutes.
I was like, well, you know, we made a really bad recovery of it too. I think.
I think they all
know that we as leaders of this fine organization failed miserably in our job, but that is sort of American's way now. Anyway. Enough of that. Here we go. Let's do this again. And we will make the key change. So that's make sure we get that G. Hey, good morning. You're in time for Primrose Lane if you set up quick. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Primrose Lane. Life's a holiday on Primrose Lane. Just a holiday on Primrose Lane with you. Can't explain when we're walking down Primrose Lane. Even roses blooming in the a holiday on Primrose Lane, just a holiday on Primrose Lane with you. Da 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 da. With you. We hit it that time. We got that. Yeah, we're back. We're back in good graces. Okay, let's go on to the Four Seasons song. This was from 1964. Now, this was part of the Jersey Boys, if you've seen the play about their life. This was in the play. It only went to number 20, though, on the charts. And that's because they, at the time, they were signed to two labels, VJ and Philips. And this one came out on the Philips label, but they were literally vying for putting this. They were so popular at that point that the two record companies would send a record out, and a week later, another record would come out. So their releases were overlapping, and they ended up killing a lot of sales for both labels, but that's what they did. Now, this one starts out with a beautiful harmonica. And, of course, our harmonica specialist, John French, has decided not to join us today.
They're at a festival today.
They're at a festival.
They're playing at a festival up in the Tawas area, I think is where they are.
Oh.
The Northeastern Festival, like somewhere.
Well, I've got a place on. I've got a place on Tawas Bay. Anyway, so what you do, it opens up with a harmonica solo. Dun, dun. So that's what that is up there. So if you have a low G setup, it's do a D sharp, which is on the C string, D sharp, and then B flat is on the G string with your low G string, open G, and then on the third fret, your G on the E string, F, and then back to D sharp, and then strum twice. That's the only things that we have as far as picking in a song. Unusual chords, I think this is pretty straightforward. But this was going to be a barring chord exercise, so you're going to be barring. So there's a lot of barring on this one. Anyway, so it goes.
Just wait and see.
like that. Well, he's got a lot more money than I got. got girls still chasing him at 80-something, but anyway. Anybody get lost in that song? And you guys, just pick some, when you're looking at the chord patterns, just pick some of the chords and play what you can play. So you don't get, you know, you just pick what you want and play what you want. All right, let's do her again. That was a little bit slow. Right, Dave? All right, you're
here we go.
Yes.
Yes.
We should do
oh,
that.
You gotta go.
Yeah, there is a big bass line on it. Here we go. Of course, this was written by Bob Gaudio, who wrote most of the great songs. And if you were back in those days of a certain age and gender, the East Coast had the Four Seasons, the West Coast had the Beach Boys, and so those were kind of a dueling act thing. But Bob Gaudio was fantastic writer.
They were just so different, though.
Yeah.
You know, they were so East Coast, West Coast.
Yeah, very. Yeah, polished as can be, and then laid back as could be.
But I'm sure there were times when Brian Wilson would go, man, those guys are so good.
Oh, yeah. The harmonies and everything. Harmonies were all fantastic. I'm a big, big fan of theirs. Both of them, both groups. Okay, let's move on to Come Saturday Morning. Now, this is I think there's a couple of songs today that have been in movies. But this was in the soundtrack for Sterile Cuckoo, which was starred Liza Minnelli. I don't know if you remember that movie, but I believe she got an Academy Award for it.
She had been ridiculously young when she made that movie.
Yeah, she was, and she hadn't done a nose job or anything. So she was, but it was, this was a, it went to number 9 on the Easy Listening chart, but it was nominated for an Academy Award for best song, but it lost to Raindrops Keep Falling on Your Head. So this came in second place to that. But it was written by Fred Carlin, who wrote 130 some TV and movie scores. And Dora Previn, now living in LA in 74 and when this was around, Dora Previn was married to Andre Previn, who was the conductor of the Los Angeles Philharmonic. So this was when she was still with him. They eventually divorced, and he ran off with that Mia Farrow girl. So anyway, things happen. But this is a great, great song. Now, this is a three-quarter time song. So I've got several unusual time songs today, one of which is a 6-9 song, but we're not going to play it in 6-9. But this is a three-quarter time song, so your strum is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay, so that's where we're going with it. All right, and then as far as unusual chords, you're going to see on the fourth line, second line from the bottom, a B sus. I managed to work that into about four songs today, so kind of get that. So it's B or B flat sus. All you got to do is bring your pinky finger over. Bring your pinky finger over. You can do it. God gave you four fingers, so you can use all of them on the instrument. But anyways, you'll see that as both B sus and B flat sus on several of the songs today. But here we go. Very pretty little song.
Come Saturday morning, I'm going away with my friend. Will Saturday spend till the end of the day? Just I and my friend will travel for miles in a Saturday smile, and then we'll move on. But then remember, long after Saturday's gone, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, I'm going away with my friend. Will Saturday more than half of the day? Just I and my friend, dressed up in our rings and our Saturday things, and then we'll move on. But we will Saturday's gone, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Just I and my friend, will travel for miles in our Saturday smiles, and then we'll move on. But we will remember long after Saturday gone, come Saturday morning. Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning.
stop there. Okay. That was a little bit slower than the normal. Anybody get lost? And I forgot to point out that F sharp minor is on the second fret. So yes.
A little bit of help on the counting. Are those all four counts?
Yes. No, well, it's a three-count song.
Three-count.
Yes, yes. Yes. So you basically, you do it, it's a minor, remember I told you we're going to be doing a lot of key changes. So it's interesting the way the key changed right there for just that section of, and then right back to, you know, the D sharp. But they make a small key change there. So anyway, so it's a come Saturday, when you're at the F, come Saturday, and then a D sharp, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that final D is a six count, okay? Everybody got that? So when you're on this top of the second page, where it goes F, you're playing along normally, and then I put these in parentheses. People are supposed to sing, which is also part of the program. You bring two instruments to this meeting. Singing is legitimate and okay. We appreciate it. But anyway, there's a layering of the Saturday, but then it's all two count. It's all three counts, so it's. Sharp. A D sus and then the six counts on the last one. Okay, let's do her again. Let's do it a little bit faster.
Come Saturday morning, I'm going away with my friend. Will Saturday spend till the end of the day? Just I and my friend will travel 4 miles in a Saturday smile, and then we'll move on. But then we'll remember long after Saturday's gone. Come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, I'm going away with my friend. Will Saturday laugh more than half of the day? Just I and my friend, dressed up in our rings and our Saturday things, and then we'll move on. But we will remember Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, do 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 do. Just I and my friend, my friend, travel 4 miles in our Saturday smile, and then we'll move on. But we will remember long after Saturday's gone. Come Saturday morning, come Saturday morning, Saturday morning.
That's enough. That's good. It obviously fades out, goes away. That's a pretty song. It's a very pretty song.
I don't know if I've ever heard it.
Really? You never saw the movie?
I may have seen that movie at the drive-in a million years ago.
Well, you were doing other things.
Preoccupied.
And frankly, you know, again, this was her pre-nose job days. She was not a very attractive woman. So, does anybody remember the sterile cuckoo? It got nominated for Academy Award, and she got, I think she won an Academy Award for it. So, did I do something to offend him? Okay, here we go. Hey, baby. Now, this is, this also had a big opening harmonica piece. And the guy who did the harmonica was a guy named Delbert McClinton, and when Bruce Channel took this song to, went number one for 3 weeks in 1962, and he went over on tour into England. What do we got going?
I'm going to just move this just
slightly,
like a foot that way.
We're having some technical issues, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah,
take the slack out of, or to put some slack into it. Okay. Anyway, so he went on tour with Bruce Channel in England, playing the harmonica, and the fascinating thing was this is that there was a guy in the audience named John Lennon, and John listened to this guy play harmonica and talked him into coming over and teaching him how to play it, and he then immediately went and recorded "Love Me Do," so all the harmonica stuff, which is also one of the songs we'll be playing a little bit later from the Beatles, thanks to. Delbert McClinton for teaching John how to play the harmonica and got the Beatles into a whole new, little bit of a grittier phase in the early days. So anyway, this Anne Murray also took this to number one in 1982. So we got 20 years apart, number one hits with this. So what do we have that's unusual here? Basically nothing. It's a four chord song, but we do have a key change, don't we? No, we don't have a key change on this one. I'm sorry. But it's a four chord, so it's... Hey. So it's basically you're just playing those four chords for the most of it. But you'll remember this song. I know. So here we go. One, two, three, four.
Say, come on, baby, give me a whirl. I my girl. Hey, baby, I wanna know if you'll be my girl.
Anyway, Bruce did a good job, but again, there we go. We got somebody that likes that song. Hi, girl. Now, I'm struggling with some of these because these, again, are all keyed to the actual recording. So you can play along with it. And, of course, he was probably 16 when he did the song. Those dudes don't sing in that key anymore either. Exactly. Okay, so here we go. The Mighty Quinn. This is a fascinating song because it was actually on part of the basement tapes, the 1967 basement tapes of Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan wrote this song. But it wasn't until, what's that? Well, it is eventually, but when his original thing was 67, which was never released, the basement tapes were never to be released. So anyway, it was there. But then Manfred Mann heard it and said, you know, I think we could do something with this. And so in 68, they released it and went to number one in the UK, number 10 in the US, number four on Cashbox, which used to be the old drop the coins in the jukebox chart. And it's been done by the Grateful Dead, and it used to be the closing song for all the Grateful Dead concerts afterwards. Hollies did it, Fish did it, but it used to be also known as Quinn the Eskimo. And then they changed it, Manfred Mann changed the name to the Mighty Quinn, so you'll see it under different names and titles.
I'm going to make a confession here.
Well, and bless you for all of that.
I always thought this was a drug song. I thought there was a drug reference. I honestly thought the lyrics, until yesterday, I honestly thought the lyrics were, when Quinn the Eskimo gets here, everybody's going to want a dose.
Oh. This is the problem.
I honestly thought that was the lyrics.
It is not the lyrics, and it has, you know, in classic Bob Dylan, this makes no damn sense at all, most of this. I mean, the guy got a Nobel Prize for literature or something. Or, you know, most of his stuff is like this. I mean, you look at this. Everybody's building it. But anyway, crazy song. And, you know, Quinn the Eskimo's going to hear and pigeons are going to run to him. Can't beat that. You just can't beat a lyric line like that. Pigeons are going to run to him. So anyway, but it starts off with the, oh my gosh, I just went blank, help me out here. We whistle it. There it is. Come on without, come on within, you'll not see nothing like the Mighty Quinn. Come all without, come all within, you'll not see nothing like the Mighty Quinn. Everybody's building ships and boats. Some are building monuments, others are jotting down notes. Everybody's in despair, every girl and boy. But when Quinn the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna jump for joy. Come all without, come all within, you'll not see nothing like the Mighty Quinn. Come all without, come all within, you'll not see nothing like the Mighty Quinn. To go just like the rest, like my sugar sweet, but jumping queues and making haste just ain't my cup of meat. Everybody's beneath the trees feeding pigeons on a limb. When Quinn the Eskimo gets here, all the pigeons gonna run to him. Come all without,
from all within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Come all without, come all within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Let me do what I want to do. I can't decide them all. Just tell me where to put them, and I'll tell you who to call. Nobody can get no sleep. There's someone on everyone's toes. But when Quentin the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna want a doze. Come all without, come all within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Come all without, come all within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. We'll just stop there. That's brutal. Anyway, people love the song. But you can see that there's some very interesting lyric lines that are in here. But everybody get lost in it. Now, one thing about this compared to the actual record, there are different versions of the Manfred Mann, so that instrumental on the second page is not in a couple of them because they needed to shorten the song up a little bit for radio. So some of them have it and some of them don't. So if you're playing along with it when you go home and say, gee, I want to really learn that song, just be aware that extra instrumental part where the whistling on the second page is not necessarily going to be in the version that's on that you're going to be hearing. Anybody want to do that one again? We got one Doc. Doc wants to do it. I just love it.
Good way to get that B to ring a little bit better.
Which one?
That every B is in boy. It's kind of called it falling flat.
Where are we?
There's just no resonance to it.
I know, because we're not a full band. Which come all without, which where are we talking about? Yeah, I can't. It's not, all I got is what I got. All right. We got quite a few songs, so let's just move on. Not that we don't love Bob and that, but, you know, let's get on to Wayne Newton. Wayne Newton. This was actually written Donkashane. So we've also got some, today we've got several songs today that have foreign languages involved, this being one of them. Clearly, Donkashane in German is thank you. And then down on the last line, Auf Wiedersehen is au revoir, bye. Anyway, so this was a 1963 hit for Wayne Newton, and it took him to the top. This was his first big hit, and it was originally written for, and Bert Kempfer did it as an instrumental in 1959, and it sat there. But in 63, they put English lyrics to it. Bobby Darin was supposed to get it as a follow-up to Mack the Knife, but he heard Wayne singing in Las Vegas in a lounge and said, I think that guy needs that song. And he took it, and that's what launched the amazing, weird career of Bobby Darin. So anyway, went to 13 on the top 100 and number 3 on the Easy Listening charts, and it came back again big in 1986 because it was part of the Ferris Bueller soundtrack. So here we go. Okay, what I want you to do before you bail is just play along with the chords that you know. So if there's a C, just play the C. Oh, you can't see it. Okay. Write to me and I'll get you hooked up and apply at the Groups.io site for LAF membership, and then you get all the music and you get it downloaded, and it's always good to have it in case. Yeah, you put it on a pad and it makes it a lot easier. Because although we do have the video board, sometimes you can see it, like you said, sometimes you can't, and, you know, sometimes we got a lot of people, and it's like you can't, you're in the back, and you're like, ugh. So, yeah, iPads are good, and I like good old, they can't, you can't, this will never fail me. You know, just old plain old plain old print them out. Anyway, so here we go with Dankeschön. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Dankeschön, darling, Dankeschön. Thank you for all the joy and pain. Picture shows, second balcony was the place with me. Second seat, go Dutch treat. You were sweet, Dankeschön, darling, Dankeschön. Save those lies, darling, don't complain. I recall Central Park in fall, how you tore your dress, what a mess. I confess, that's not all. Dankeschön, darling, Dankeschön. Thank you for walks down Lover's Lane. I can see hearts carved on a tree, letters intertwined. For all time, yours and mine, that was fine. Dankeschön, darling, Dankeschön. Thank you for seeing me again. Though we go on our separate ways, still the stays for always. My heart says, Dankeschön, Dankeschön. Oh, darling, Dankeschön. I say, through for seeing me again. Though we go on our separate ways, still the memory stays for always. My heart says, Dankeschön, Dankeschön. Auf Wiedersehen. Dankeschön. So we had how many key changes? Five. Think E flat to E, F, actually six key changes. So, what's that? Dankeschön? It means thank you. He's thanking her for leaving him. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for leaving him. It was so. If you're in Germany, Dankeschön is you thank you. So that's one of our songs. Okay. So do we? What's that? I don't know. I have a very close friend who's a German. He's a German professor. But whenever I'm in Germany, when I was in Germany, Dankeschön was like thank you. Just after I built you up to the crowd about how wonderful you were, and now you tell me you failed German? Well, you know, I struggled. Let's just say we struggled. Okay, do we want to do this one again, or everybody done with Wayne? Are you done with Wayne? Done with Wayne. Anyway, but the reason I put this in was so that you had all these key changes, so you can see how, you know, find a spot that you can sing. All right, here we go to Can't You Hear My Heartbeat? This was Herman's, and it went to number 2 in 1965. And couldn't break the top to break into the number 1 slot because of a song called Stop in the Name of Love that we did a few years back. But it was number 8 for the entire year of 1965, so it was a huge hit. Now, this is Triplets Day. You'll notice that at the end of the fourth line, triplets. Triplets over here, but the entire instrumental is triplets. It's fast and it's hard, but you can just play the two. So that's, but it's all triplets from on the instrumental. So it's a triplet from the E on the second line. That sets it up, and then, so we'll give it a run. Now it starts out with da 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 da. Where we messed it up. So it's one da 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 da. But those are two counts. Should we skip the intro? Is that what you? Here we go. Every time I see you looking my way, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? In the car, walking down the highway, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? When you move up close to me, I get a feeling that's ooh-wee, oh. Can't you hear the pounding of my heartbeat? 'Cause you're the one I love. You're the one I love. When I feel you put your arms around me, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Then I'm glad, I'm mighty glad I found you. You hear the pounding of my heartbeat, 'cause you're the one I love. You're the one I love. All my friends are crying out to meet you, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Now's the time to go and see the preacher, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Wedding bells are gonna chime, baby, baby, you're gonna be mine. Oh, can't you hear the pounding of my heartbeat? 'Cause you're the one I love. Thought this sounded all right. That was a little slow, though. This is a real kind of a quick tempo song. I don't want to miss anything here, so do you want to do that one again, or we want to move on? Because I want to try and cover. We're about an hour in, and let's just move on. Okay, so anyway, use the triplets on it. Practice it at home. And a triplet is, again, just it's one. All right, so let's move on to, okay. We have a temporary pause in the action. Well, while he's gone, do you want to do that song again? Huh? All right, let's do it a little faster. What's that? We're gonna do. Can't they, while he's in the bathroom, we can do the. So let's do it quicker.
Every time I see you looking my way, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? In the car or walking down the highway, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? When you move up close to me, I get a feeling that's ooh-wee. Oh, can't you hear the pounding of my heartbeat? 'Cause you're the one I love. You're the one I love. When I feel you put your arms around me, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Then I'm glad, I'm mighty glad I found you. Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? When you asked me to meet your mom, I knew that baby we'd be going far. Oh, can't you hear the pounding of my heartbeat? 'Cause you're the one I love. You're the one I love. All my friends are crying out to meet you. Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Now's the time to go and see the preacher. Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Wedding bells are gonna chime. Baby, baby, you're gonna be mine. Oh, can't you hear the pounding of my heartbeat? 'Cause you're the one I love. You're the one I love. Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat?
There we go. All right, let's move on to the Al Dila. I bet no one has ever heard this song. Does anybody go to the YouTube and play these in advance? No. Oh, one does. Steve, thank you. This is a gorgeous song. And it was part of the Eurovision Song Contest in 1961, and it came in fifth. But it was also used in a movie called Rome Adventure. And there's lots of Italian versions of this, including Connie Francis did it in Italian. But it was written by a guy named Carlo Donita, who wrote I Who Have Nothing. I don't remember if there was a guy, Terry Knight in the Pack from Flint, that did that, and he made a national hit out of it. I Who Have Nothing. It's a great song. But anyway, he wrote that. But the English lyrics were added by a guy named Irwin Drake, and he was the guy who wrote I Believe, and it was a very good year for Frank Sinatra. So anyway. Very pretty little song. So got to slow it way down. And this is, again, Italian. So al di là means beyond in English. So al di là.
La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Star, where you walk, flowers bloom. When you smile, all the gloom turns to sunshine, and my heart opens wide. When you're gone, it fades inside and seems to have died. Al-di-la, I wonder as I drifted where you are. Al-di-la, the fog around me lifted, there you were. And the kiss that I gave was the love I have saved for a lifetime. Then I knew all of you was completely mine. Key change. That I gave was the love that I have saved for a lifetime. Then I knew all of you was completely mine.
Gorgeous song. Gorgeous song. Isn't that pretty? Isn't that a pretty song? Okay, I'm Beatles song that we've got in the package today. And this was off of their original 63 album, Please Please Me. And so it never really got a full release. And the interesting thing is both Lennon claims he wrote it, and he said he was writing it as a Motown song, which is kind of odd because it doesn't have any kind of feel for Motown that I can feel. And McCartney later on, after he had died, claimed that he wrote the song. And it feels more like a John Lennon song. And what I read that was more important is that it was more his response to Brian Wilson writing In My Room. And that makes sense the way this plays. So, I don't know if you remember this song. There's nothing really unusual other than a C sharp minor is fourth fret. On the end of the first line, end of the second line, those are fourth fret up there. So what does that start as?
Everybody practice that G sharp minor too before we get rolling here.
Yeah.
It's a hard one to hit.
Where is? Oh yeah. Yeah. What's that? It's B with a pinky. B with a pinky. Bring your pinky on the E string. I finger it the normal way, but yes. You also can just, what I do is I drop that on the G string. I put it this way. I put it, I don't try to hit that triangle pattern. So you can also do a cheat on this one by just strumming the top three strings. Don't strum the G if you have a hard time hitting it. But thank you, that's a good suggestion. Okay, here we go. I can't remember how it starts. Uh-oh. We're about to lose our bass player. It's charged up. Okay, here we go. Ready? What is it? All right, help me out here. What's the beginning of this? Is I can't remember. I went blank. The beginning of it is the intro. Anybody know this?
You just play that. Isn't it just four beats on each?
Yeah, no. It's specific. See, this is why I key these directly to the song. It's a very distinctive intro. And why I'm going blank on it, I don't know. Beatles, there's a place. All right, bear with me, I'm sorry. Have to watch the commercial. Anyway, at least you got paid. Okay. This is the harmonica stuff. So going back to our Hey Babe, this is where John learned how to play the harmonica. So, okay, here we go. We're ready to play it.
There's a place where I can go when I feel low, when I feel blue, and in my mind, and there's no time when I'm alone. I think of you, the things you do go round my head, the things you said, like I love only you. In my mind there's no sorrow, don't you know that it's so? There'll be no sad tomorrow, don't you know that it's so? There's a place where I can go when I feel low, when I feel blue, and in my mind, and there's no time There's a place.
Good 2 minute song. Anybody want to do that one again?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. All right. Anybody have struggles with that G sharp minor? Again, it's just like if you use your three fingers for your D, for your E, for your G, this kind of stuff makes it much easier because then you can just slide up. If you're used to doing your G minor, then you just slide up and drop your index finger in. Okay, here we go.
There's a place where I can go when I feel low, when I feel blue, and in my mind, and there's no time when I'm alone. I think of you, things you do go round my head, the things you said, like I love only you. In my mind there's no sorrow, don't you know that it's so? There'll be no sad tomorrow, don't you know that it's so? There's a place where I can go when I feel low, when I feel blue, and in my mind, and there's no time when I'm alone. There's
There's a place. Kind of an unusual song for them. I like that a lot. Okay, now we're going to play one of the great American standard songs. Written by George and Ira Gershwin in 1928, so we're going way back. Yeah, interestingly, it was in two Broadway musicals at the same time, Treasure Girl, which nobody remembers, but it was also in Strike Up the Band, and everybody does remember that one. That was a very big musical and turned into a movie. Now, Brian did this reimagining Gershwin. So he played it. If you listen to the recommended YouTube video, which nobody other than Steve and I have spent any time with, he plays it as a doo-wop song. So it starts out with... I got a crush on you. So all of it is the doo-wop, a wop, a wop, a doo-wop. So he plays it and gives it an interpretation. As all great songs, you can, you know, play with them, and he did with this one. So here we go. I got a crush on you, sweetie pie, all the day and night time. Hear me sigh, I never had the least notion that you could fall with such emotion. Could you coo? Could you care for a cunning cottage? We could share the world, will pardon my mush. 'Cause I have got a crush, my baby, on you. Doo-doo. What up, what a da 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 da, whop, da 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 da. I've got a crush on you. Could you coo? Could you care for a cunning cottage? We could share the world, will pardon my mush. 'Cause I have got a crush, my baby, on you, on you, on you, on you, on you. Wop, wop, my baby, on you. Wop, 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 my baby, on you. Twop, wop, 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 my baby, on you. Wop, 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 my baby, on you.
Let's just end it there. You get the picture. So that's a fun song, and it's a great, great standard. And again, I want to keep moving, so I don't... Anybody want to do that one again? It's a pretty song. Let's move on to Blondie. Call Me. So this is a driving song, and it was a disco song. It was a disco song. It was written by Giorgio Moroder, who was the... Giorgio Moroder, who is the, he did Donna Summer's records, a bunch of the disco songs. It was huge in 1980, but this was part of the movie American Gigolo, and Debbie Harry wrote the lyrics to this, and it was a number one song for 6 weeks, and it was the biggest Blondie hit they ever had. It was the biggest Blondie hit they ever had. And the song is about a prostitute. So it ties in with the American Gigolo. So the whole thing is her offering herself. So anyway, the intro is one.
Color me your color, baby. Color me your car. Color me your color, darling. I know who you are. Come up off your color chart. I know where you're coming from. Call me on the line. Call me, call me, call me anytime. Call me, I'll arrive. You can call me any day or night. Call me. Cover me with kisses, baby. Cover me with love. Roll me in designer sheets. I'll never get enough. Emotions come, I don't know why. Cover up love's alibi. Call me on the line. Call me, call me, call me anytime. Call me, I'll arrive. When you're ready, we can share the wine. Call me. Speaks the languages of love. Ooh, amor, Chamonix, Chamonix. Ooh, appelle-moi, mon, mon chéri, appelle-moi. Any time, any place, anywhere, anyway. Any time, any place, any day, anywhere. Six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
My life, call me in a sweet design. Call me for your lover, lover's alibi. Call me inner line. Call me any time. Call me, oh, call me. Child here. I feel bad about things.
When I listened to the YouTube video, I got into like the 12-minute disco version.
Oh, go, go, yeah. Oh, no, no, yeah, no. It goes on. No, no. This is the best of Blondie. If you're going to want to play this at home, look for the best of Blondie YouTube video. So they give her the regular side. So we got enough time to do that one again. Everybody seemed to be singing, which I like. So let's do that. Let's do it again because I think we might have enough time here. So I hate to skip songs like we did that beautiful song, but anyway, here. Okay, one, one, two, three, four.
Color me your color, baby. Color me your car. color me your color, darling, I know who you are. Come up off your color chart, I know where you're coming from. Call me on the line, call me anytime. Call me, I'll arrive, you can call me any day or night. Call me. Cover me with kisses, baby, cover me with love. Roll me in designer sheets, I'll never get enough. Emotions come, I don't know why. Cover up love's alibi, hold it. Call me on the line, call me anytime. Call me, I'll arrive when you're ready, we can share the wine. Call me. Speaks the languages of love. Ooh, amor, Chamonix. Ooh, Applemore, mon chéri, Applemore. Anytime, any place, anywhere, anyway. Anytime, any place, anywhere, any day, anyway. Call me for some overtime. Call me in my life. Call me in a sweet design. Call me for your lover's, lover's alibi. Call me inner line. Call me any time. Call me, oh, call me.
That's a good song. See, some, not everything from the disco era was drivel. Some there were some good driving songs. I saw I watched a special on Donna Summer. If it's on HBO, I think there's a special on two of them that I'd recommend. One is on Dionne Warwick, and the other one was on Donna Summer. It's very good. Now, this song you probably do not know. But I absolutely love this song, and it's Jennifer Warrens, who's one of my favorite artists, and she is a singer's singer. And by that, I mean that she was brought in for all kinds of soundtracks. She had her own stuff going. Her most famous record is Famous Blue Raincoat, where she had a collaboration with Leonard Cohen, and it's a terrific, terrific album. And then, of course, she had huge, huge, huge number ones, winning Academy Awards for Up Where We Belong, which is a number one hit off of The Officer and a Gentleman. This song only went to number 40 on a top adult contemporary and didn't even break the top 100. But it's a beautiful song, and I want to play it for you. Now, it's got quick changes. So on the end of the lines, the F minor is... So the F minor, the B flat, and the C minor back to B flat are quick. And it sets up, and you'll find that on all of those where you see them bunched together on the first page of that, it's because of their quick changes. But you'll hear it when I play it. But her voice is absolutely clear as a bell, and she doesn't get the recognition that she really should. And I think Mark was with me in California, and we were at McCabe's guitar shop out there, and she actually came in and performed at the McCabe's Guitar Ship. And who else was with her that night? I can't remember who backed her up. Jackson Brown. So she's incredible. Anyway. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. No, she's absolutely phenomenal. You know, but she does not get the kind of recognition that some of them do. And she should, because she's phenomenal. And I recently got a turntable out. I got my old turntable out. Mark's been working on it with me. And I pulled out this record, and I've heard this song again. Well, this was 1982, and I realized how much I love this song. So this is one of those Indulge Me.
When you're searching for someone to believe in, when you're wasting all your time, and your lovers, they fade into the distance, when it's love that you still can't find, come to me, to the one who really loves you. Come to me, to me, I'm the one who longs to hold you. Come to me, to me, I'm the one who wants to show you how it feels, how it feels. When you're facing one more broken promise, but your cries have gone unheard. So many people say they want to love you, but you don't believe a word. Come to me, I'm the one who really knows you. Come to me, to me, to the one who longs to hold you. Come to me, to me, I'm the one who wants to show you how it feels, how it feels. When your lovers, they fade into the distance, and it's love you still can't find, come to me, I'm the one who really knows you. Come to me, to me, to the one who longs to hold you. Come to me, to me, I'm the one who wants to show you how it feels, how it feels. Come to me, to the one who really loves you. Come to me, to me, to the one who longs to hold you. Come to me, to me, I'm the one who wants to show you how it feels, how it feels.
Beautiful song, isn't it? Isn't that lovely? Yeah, well, it's a tough one, but I mean, as far as the beauty of the song, I mean, these are aspirational kind of songs. If you learn to love it, you want to learn to play it. I mean, this has got some funky chords in it, that A-flat major 7, but it's a beautiful sound. To be resolved with a B-flat. It's a gorgeous song, gorgeous song. All right, we will, in terms of time, we're going to move on. Honolulu Lulu. And we'll play this once. This is our pseudo Hawaiian song of the day. Jan and Dean, and I don't know if you know the history of Jan and Dean, but it's a phenomenal story. Obviously, they had Dead Man's Curve and Surf City USA and wonderful songs, and they're very close with the Beach Boys. And if you ever hear Barbara Ann by the Beach Boys, it's actually Jan singing it. But he had a terrible car crash, ironically right near where Dead Man's Curve is, and he had brain damage. But Dean Torrance never left him. And to this day, they still perform together. Anyway, here we go. Queen of the Surfer Girl. She's got stars in her eyes and knobs on her knees now. Crazy grass swift really sways in the breeze now. Riding down a heavy or a line in the sand. She's the hippest girl in the land. And she's my Honolulu. She's my Honolulu. Queen of the Surfer Girls. Well, she handles all the big ones every year in Makaha. And all the surfers know her from Rincon to Baja. When the beach is quiet and you know we're out of luck, we pray for surf while making out in our truck. Just me and Honolulu. Me and Honolulu. Queen of the Surfer Girl. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. She's my Honolulu. She's my Honolulu. Queen of the Surfer Girls. I tell you, once upon a time, you know, she got a little bold. And when she tried to hook a spinner, but her wax wouldn't hold. Over the falls instead of hanging down. Then she'd paddle out and try it again. Cause she's my Honolulu. She's my Honolulu. Queen of the Surfer Girl. Ooh. Okay, so that slide, I forgot to explain a slide. It's just so that's what that is at the end of it. So let's see what we, how many we got more to do. Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, yeah. Okay. Anyway, it's a fun song. It's cute. Not really a Hoppa Howley song, but you know. I apologize. It seemed cheap and easy, and I feel so dirty about it. Anyway, some people like it. All right, so interestingly enough, Dean Torrance, again, of Jan and Dean. It was Dean Torrance is the dean of Jan and Dean. He then became also a graphic artist, and so he did in one Grammys for artwork on albums. And so the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band did this song, Mr. Bojangles, and it was written by Jeff Walker, and it is autobiographical. Now, most people think this has something to do with Bill Robinson, who was played on many, many movies with Shirley Temple, and he was considered to be the Mr. Bojangles. You know, he was a black man. It absolutely does not have anything to do with Bill Robinson. This is an autobiographical song because Jerry Jeff Walker found himself in a New Orleans jail with this guy who was called himself Bojangles, because anybody that would dance like that would, but he was a white guy, and this is all true. Yeah, he said it actually, he had to cut this song off because he had extra things about the guy losing his wife and everything else, but anyway, finally cut it down. Now, the odd thing is we see this a 6/8 time. The actual time signature of the song is 6/9, and so he was completely stunned that this thing became a big hit, because of the fact that, you know, it's a 6-9 song about a guy drunk in a jail and a dead dog. And, you know, I mean, it's like everything you wouldn't think would make a big hit out of it, but the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band did that. Now, who did the art direction for the for that album? Dean Torrence. So, tie it all together. Anyway, we're playing this as a 6-8 song because I can't do 6-9. I tried it, and it's like, I mean, it's, you know what I'm talking about. It's like ridiculous. So it's, we're, it plays just fine. 6-8 time, again, you can also like a 3/4 strum. So that's the strum pattern. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Oh, I'm sorry, I started on B. Okay, F sharp.
I knew a man, Bojangles, and he'd dance for you in worn out shoes, with silver hair, a ragged shirt, and baggy pants. The old soft shoe, he jumped so high, jumped so high. Then he lightly touched down. I met a man in a cell in New Orleans. I was down and out. He looked to me to be the eyes of Eve. As he spoke right out, he talked up. Laughed and clicked his heels and stepped. He said his name Bojangles and he danced a lick across the cell. He grabbed his pants and spread his stance, so he jumped so high. Then he clicked his heels, he let go. Let go a laugh, shook back his clothes all around. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, dance. Dance for those at minstrel shows and county fairs throughout the South. He spoke through tears of 15 years how his dog and him traveled about. The dog up and died, up and died. After 20 years, he still grieves. He said, I dance now at every chance in honky-tonks for drinks and tips. But most of the time I spend behind these county bars, 'cause I drinks a bit. He shook his head, as he shook his head, heard someone ask him, please, please, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles.
Interesting song. How many more we got to go? A couple more? All right, that's a long one, so maybe we ought to. Let's move on to Carefree Highway. There's nothing really difficult on that song, but again, it's the timing. The signature timing is bad. Now, on Carefree Highway, I have to admit there's a couple of mistakes. On the chorus, when you get to the chorus, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 lines down, it's "Let me slip away, not on you." Don't do that. It's "Let me slip away on you." So I'm going to have to correct that, and I will correct it and repost this song for all you people at home. And then on the second page, on the outro, on the very last line, over "let," there should be an A. There should be an A being played there. Okay? So other than that, so the reason I included this, and the last two songs today are going to be for, one of them was requested, which, disappointing that she didn't come today. But both these people died recently. Gordon Lightfoot died. Great Canadian troubadour. I was going to do Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald, but it's about a 22-page song. It goes on and on. Huh? Don't let it. I've got some four pagers this year. I got to warn you. One of them is MacArthur's Park. So, this is an easy one here, but we're going to move up the stage a little bit. But anyway, I got MacArthur's Park as a four pager. So I got a couple of four pagers. So, but I didn't do. Maybe I still will. But he's very literal in that song. I mean, he really gets the details down on the Edmund Fitzgerald. But anyway, we did Sundown last year. And this is the second single off of the Sundown album. And it went to number 10 on the top 100, number 1 on the easy listening chart. And it was this, it's a good, strong song. Anyway, here we go. Oh, one other thing is this is that when you see on the second page, it says repeat chorus until bing. So the third time through the chorus, you'll see an asterisk over here. You go a D, A, and then you immediately go to "Let Me Slip Away on You" on the outro. So hopefully you're completely confused, and here we go. So. Let's see. Picking up the pieces of my sweet shattered dreams. Wonder how the old folks are tonight. Her name was Anne, and I'll be damned if I recall her face. She left me not knowing what to do. Carefree highway, let me slip away on you. Carefree highway, you've seen better days, morning after blues. From my head down to my shoes. Carefree highway, let me slip away, slip away on you. Of the times are we once best. I wonder if she'll ever do the same. Now the thing that I call living is just being satisfied, not knowing how and nothing left to blame. Carefree highway, let me slip away on you. Carefree highway, you've seen better days, morning after blue, from my head down to my shoes. Carefree highway, let me slip away on you. Play the whole instrumental. Searching through the fragments of my dreams' shattered sleep, I wonder. wonder if the years have closed her mind. Well, I guess it must be wanderlust or trying to get free from the good old faithful feeling we once knew. Carefree highway, let me slip away on you. Carefree highway, you've seen better days. Morning after blues, from my head down to my shoes. Carefree highway, let me slip away, slip away on you. D, A, let me slip away on you. Carefree highway, got to see you, my old flame. Carefree highway, you've seen better days. Morning after blues, I head down to my shoes. Carefree highway, hey, let me slip away, slip away on you. That was a little slower than what it's supposed to be, but we are got to move on to our last song, and this was requested, and it's Girl from Ipanema, and this was a huge, huge record all around the world, and it got the won the Grammy in 1964 for Best Recording, Best Album. It won the Best Album for Jazz and Album of the Year, and it was Stan Getz. Excuse me, Stan Getz and Oe Gilberto. Astrid, his wife, this was originally written for Ella Fitzgerald. And I love Ella Fitzgerald. Her voice is phenomenal. Again, clarity is incredible. I can't see her singing this song, but they didn't either. When they went into the thing, they thought it was going to be Ella, and they listened to it, and they said, eh. And he brought in Oe Gilberto, brought in his wife Astrid to sing this song, and her had never been recorded before. She had never sung before professionally, and yet the airy quality was what made it. Right, right. So,
but she knew it just exotically.
Just exotic, yes. So the airy fairy kind of the way she sings it is just it's terrific. So anyway,
no emotion.
Now there's a couple. There's one hard section here. Now you're at the fifth fret on that first one. That F major 7 is a fifth fret to give it that. But we're gonna have a bossa nova. Now the father of bossa nova is this owl. It's J-O-A-O. So I don't know how to pronounce the Portuguese gao. Gilberto is what was the guy who wrote this. It's Portuguese. This is from Brazil. And this was the song that made Rio famous for the beach. It was not really big until this song came out in the 60s, and then it came up. And it is based on a real girl that walked back and forth in front of these guys every day and drove them nuts. And then they did so, and she ended up having lines of bikinis and stuff like that. No, I know, but it drove all the tourism, and now it is because, you know, Ipanema is like unbelievable. But anyway, so it's. So that's the basic beat of the thing, is a bossa nova beat. And so he just lightly just brushed the strings. What's that? I put it at the end. Oh, I added it. Well, it's on. It's in. If you go to the I put. I sent it out two ways. One, I did just a regular blast, so if you're on the email list, you should have gotten it separately, and then also a notification that I put it in the songs. But if you don't, it's in the group's I.O. stuff. I did not put it in the Google Drive, but it's in the group's I.O. spot, and you should, if you look in your emails, you should have gotten a... Yeah. Oh, it should have been right there. It's listed in the file, so you got it. So anyway, let's play it so we can go home. Anyway. It's a great song. And this, you know, the other thing about it is about a minute and a half song because of the way I've charted it here. Now, on the bridge, that G flat major 7 is a hard chord to hit. So I've given you an alternative chord, which is the 6th fret. And then you drop down to the B9. And then the F sharp major 7 is the second fret. And then the D9. But it's a beautiful chord changes on that. Anyway, so here we go. All right, 1 and 2.
Tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema come walking. When she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gentle. When she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. But I watch her so sadly. How can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly. But each day when I walk to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall and tan and young and lovely, girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes I smile, but she doesn't see. She doesn't see. No, she doesn't see. Tall and tan and young and lovely, girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gentle, that when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. Oh, but I watch her so sadly. How can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly. But each day when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Young and tall and tan and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes I smile, but she doesn't see. She just doesn't see. No, she just doesn't see.
Rest in peace, both Astrid and Gordon. So unfortunately we're getting more and more of these every day. So great guys for the 60s.
I gotta remember this, because this is just...
It's great.
Such a great tune to just pass the solos around the room.
Right, yeah. Not this room, but other rooms. I'm just kidding. He would be great.
He could have done that.
Oh, yeah.
He was... You had a solo in your head. I just...
Well, come on up and we'll... we got to go. Thank you all for coming. Thank you, people on our feed. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or anything, give me a call or write, email me, rather, it would be better. Always here to try to help you learn and enjoy. Hope we didn't stretch it too much, but pretty wide variety today, as usual, when I'm here. So Anyway, thank you all.